amazing artist. I hope you enjoyed learning all about Rembrandt and the Baroque period. Now that we've learned about Rembrandt and his picture, The Night Watch, we're going to make our own night guard. So there are three different ones that are on this page for you to look at. If you want to use those, you can. You can also use them as an inspiration and change the guard's face, because the three guards you see, they're all styled like the time period. Perhaps you want to make your night guard a little bit more modern. Maybe your night guard is going to be a picture of you. Let's get started. So for this project, we're going to use a black piece of construction paper and some oil pastels. Now, if you don't have oil pastels, you can also use crayon on black construction paper, and that works just fine. If you don't have crayon or oil pastels, or you don't have black paper, you can do this on a white piece of paper. You can draw it just like we're drawing it with whatever you have. Just remember, you have to color the entire thing with whatever coloring materials you have. So in order to get started, I am going to take my black paper and I'm going to fold it in half twice. Once vertically, nice and tall. And then open it up. And then I'm going to do that again horizontally, like a book. When I open it up, that gives me a grid to draw with. So now when I draw, I can try and stay in different sections of my paper to make my drawing look more proportional. The idea behind this is we want our figure to look more realistic and things to be in the right place than if we were to just draw without a grid. So to help you draw, there are three worksheets that you can click on to enlarge, and they show images like Rembrandt's The Night Watch. I'm choosing to do this image, but you may choose to do, again, your own image of this, so a different version, maybe your face here, or you can pick and choose different pieces from the ones you see and make your own sort of combined version. So in order to start, I'm going to start with the shape of the head. So if I look at this drawing, even though there's a beard there, we can see the shape of the head is a U shape. So I want that shape to be in the center of my paper, and I want it to just touch the center of this grid. So I want it right here. And I'm gonna try to keep him here while I draw. I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but I'm going to try my best. So I'm gonna start here and make this U. Again, I'm doing mine in white oil pastel. You may want to do yours in pencil and then trace it later. So now that I have that U shape, I'm gonna go ahead and add his hair and his hat. So if I look at his hair, it looks like a rectangle shape with some wavy lines. This one is a little bit more curved. So I'm gonna go back to my sort of U shape. I'm gonna do a rectangle shape, just like this. And if at any point you think you need to just go back and fix a line, that's okay, because we can always turn that into part of the wave. Now I'm gonna give some wave. And then on this side, I'm gonna make this curve, just like this. For my hat, I'm gonna make the line that goes across the top here first, and then that gives me a chance to go back in and fill this hair in a little bit taller. And then I'm gonna make this bean shape that goes around, starting from the hair, around, a little dip, and around, and back to this side. So starting here, and it's quite a large hat, I'm gonna come around to the top, I'm gonna dip a little, and then I'm going to come back to this side. Now the top of my hat has a little, kind of like a rainbow shape, but it's a little bit rectangular on the side. There is one thing that I am going to change on this picture. So I'm gonna draw that hat, and I'm just gonna lightly come down. And if you look, it comes down right here by the face. But there's one thing I wanna add, and just to make this a little bit more interesting, is I'm going to make a big feather in this man's hat, just like in the other image. So I'm gonna make a curve line here and up, another curve line from here, And then another one coming up this way, because I want to see a big feather in this man's hat. All right, so now that I have the hair and the hat, I'm going to draw the shoulders of my picture. So let me bring this up so you can see it. So in this case, he's wearing a collar, so his shoulders don't really come out and square down like they would normally do. They come out at a diagonal. So that's what we want to show. So I'm going to come over. I'm going to draw a little bit of my neck over here. Just a little bit, just to show that he's got his collar on. I'm going to come over, go below, now below the fold for the shoulders, to the edge of the paper. And I'm going to do the same thing on this side, starting from the face, coming down and below the line. Now I'm going to go back up to my face and I'm going to draw the face. So I'm going to make this as simple as I can. Now this is what's called a three-quarter view, which means we can see not half of the face, not the entire face, but three quarters of the face. So this part is a little bit cut off from the way he is sitting. So I always like to start by marking where the eyes and nose and mouth go. So if I'm looking at my paper, the eyes are near the top. So I'm just gonna make a little mark. There's one eye that goes about here and one eye that's here. I'm gonna mark where the nose is, which comes down from this eye. And then I'm gonna mark where the mouth would be, which would be right here. Now I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna draw these shapes more realistically. So I'm gonna come in and make the nose. Make the oval shape of the eye. And this is a shorter oval because it is foreshortened. A bigger eye on this side. My eyebrow. My mouth. And then I'm going to add my facial hair just to show that this man has on a beard. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to make some lines kind of going down past my chin. And then I'm going to make his mustache. Just like that. And you can make your hair a little bit more curvy. Now this is where you can kind of fix things. We are going to color this. Okay. So my next step now is to go in and start adding the details on his clothing. So I'm going to finish the collar. It is a wavy line, and then it comes back up to the chin to make a little triangle here, and then another wavy line across. So that's what I'm going to do next. I'm going to start over here. Wavy line. When I get to the chin, I'm going to go up. I'm going to do that down. Make a little skinny triangle. And then come back to this side. The next layer is just a curved line for this part of the collar. So I'm going to come in and make a curved line. And then he has a sash. So the sash curves down here and makes this moon shape. Curve down and up like this. So I'm going to go back to my collar. I'm going to curve down to the center. I'm trying to keep everything on the center line here. Then come back over and connect to my collar. Now I'm going to add the wavy line that's underneath this one. So I'm going to come down and make a wavy line. Just like that. And then I do that one more time because there's two of these layers. So I'm going to go back to my shoulder. I'm going to come down, make another wavy line, and come up and connect, just like that. Now I'm going to add the open part of his shirt here. So this is a rectangle with some design on it. I'm going to go back to my center, make my rectangle all the way down. And then I can add some lines for my design. All right, last step. There's just a line right here for the arm. I'm gonna go back here and make my line. That is my drawing. Now, I'm going to go in and I'm going to color this. Now we want to think about how Rembrandt used color, because Rembrandt used shadow and light to make his artwork more dramatic. So as I color these, I want to make sure that I'm adding some shadows to my design. So let me show you what I mean. I'm going to take any color. I think I'll do a blue hat. So I'm going to do my hat in blue. And then I'm going to take a darker blue, or you can use a brown or a black, and I'm going to add some shadow to this. So I'm going to color the hat. I'll show you on this piece. I'm going to color this piece nice and full with my oil pastel or crayon or whatever you're coloring with. And now I'm going to go back with this darker color, and on this side of the hat, I'm going to add a shadow. I'm blending a shadow with the other color. I like to use oil pastels for this because you can really see the blending. If you're using crayon, you have to really make sure that you're mixing your two colors together to get it to look blended. Color pencil and marker sometimes will work a little bit better. So now you can see I have this nice shadow on here. I'm going to show you the next part of the hat. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to color it with my lighter color. And now I'm going to do those dramatic shadows. So I got my darker color, and I'm going to do some shadows on the back part of this hat. That seems to be where the back of the shadow is. And then I'm also going to do some on the brim here, to show that there is a shadow here, and then some kind of around the face. It's creating a shadow underneath this hat. If you want something even more dramatic, you can add a little bit of black to this. And then I usually just like to blend it with my finger so it's not too stark, but it is still showing a really dark shadow here. Okay, can you see how that's starting to look a little bit more 3D and a little bit more like light is not hitting this area of the hat, but it's hitting other spots? So you're going to continue in that manner through the whole picture. You need to think about where your shadows are going to be and try to keep them on the same side. So since I already have shadows on my left side, when I do his body, my shadows are going to be on the left side here. And then I need to think about when I have folds of clothing, what happens to those folds of clothing. So I'm actually just going to unroll my sleeve so you guys can see what that looks like. So if I have a piece of clothing and it is blocking the light, do you see how there's a dark area in here? Anywhere the light is blocking it, it's going to create a shadow. If I fold my shirt, there we go, it's also going to create shadows in those folds. So there's a shadow that gets created here in these folds, and you can see underneath here another shadow. So when I'm doing my rest of my picture, not only am I going to have shadows on my left side, but if there is a piece of clothing that's on top of something else, like this collar or this sash, I want to do a little bit of shadow kind of underneath here. So I do a little bit of shadow under here and under here to show that it's sitting on top of my person. For my face, I can just keep the shadows all on this side, and then maybe a little bit of a shadow here on this side of the nose where the light would be hitting. All right, so go ahead and get out your coloring materials and finish coloring your Rembrandt.
I've been reading books of old, the legends and the myths, Achilles and his gold, Hercules. Hercules and his gifts, Spider-Man's control, and Batman with his fists. And clearly I don't see myself upon that list. But she said, where you wanna go, how much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, some fairy tale bliss, just something I can turn to, somebody I can miss.
My Rembrandt inspired guard. I'm gonna go ahead and sign my name and then upload your image to the Google Classroom. I can't wait to see all of the creative figures that you guys have drawn.